Antarctica, the underside of our fair planet. Did you know that down there, right at the southern tippity point, is over 26.5 million cubic kilometres of ice jammed up and packed together in an absolutely colossal ice sheet that comprises the frozen continent? Now, in a completely hypothetical apocalyptic scenario, imagine that all of that ice was suddenly melted by, oh, I don't know, a rapid change in the temperature of the Earth's atmosphere, and without warning, melted. Yes, melted ice equals water, but that's a hell of a lot of ice and an even larger whole lot of H2O. So where would it all go, and what devastating effects would it have on our planet's ecosystem? Well, let's find out. Hello internet, and once again welcome back to the most inquisitive channel on YouTube, Life's Biggest Questions. As per usual, I'll be your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch, as today we curiously ask the question, what if all the ice melted in Antarctica? Roll the clip. For the curious amongst you, that clip was from the only end of days global disaster movie that you'll ever need, The Day After Tomorrow, because, come on, what did you expect? 2012? No thanks, buddy. But it also actually presents a pretty robust scenario when it comes to the polar ice cap melting, mainly being apocalyptic level weather currents and continental sized storms. But is that the only thing that would happen if all the ice melted in Antarctica? Well, no. Of course not. There's much more to it than that. So let's find out. First, we have to take a look at what Antarctica actually looks like. I mean, it's not just some huge hunk of ice bobbing listlessly in the ocean, is it? No, in fact, deep down beneath the frozen core, Antarctica would be a pretty awesome place, actually. More than 170 million years ago, Antarctica was part of the supercontinent known as Gondwana, which comprised what we know today as South America, Africa, Australia, the Indian subcontinent, and of course, Antarctica. But back then, the area that makes up Antarctica wasn't always a cold, dry, frozen desert made up of impenetrable ice sheets. In fact, it was a widely temperate climate covered in bustling and vibrant tropical forests. It even had a few dinosaurs. It is thought through cutting-edge topographical radar and satellite imagery that Antarctica would widely resemble the Andes mountain range of South America, but as chance would have it, shortly after the Gondwana breakup that occurred around 140 million years ago, Antarctica became partially isolated during its seismic breakup, and that's when things got a little bit chilly, so to speak. And around 23 million years ago, the infamous Drake Passage opened up between Antarctica and South America, resulting in what is now known as the Antarctic Circumpolar Current, completely isolating the continent, plummeting its CO2 levels, and turning its lush forest landscape into the eternal popsicle that we all know and love today. Also, penguin land, because, yeah, we can't mention Antarctica without mentioning penguins, right? But just imagine that all of that ice, all 26.5 million cubic kilometers of it, melted. Well, it would in fact melt into roughly 24.3 million cubic kilometers of water, which when added to the current volume of our oceans would result in a predicted sea level rise of about 60 meters. Guys, that's huge, and that's also really, really bad. As in, a vast number of countries across our planet will just be completely and utterly submerged, millions upon millions of people forever lost to the rising ocean, homes obliterated, coastlines rapidly ravaged without warning. It wouldn't be gradual either. It's thought that regardless of this particular rapid surge in sea levels, our oceans are already rising anyway at a rate of about 1/8 of an inch per year, which only seems to be rapidly increasing. In that scenario though, which is very much real may I add, we'd have the chance to perhaps utilize technology to diminish the crisis effects of an encroaching sea level. But in this scenario, yeah, we're talking poof, Antarctic ice equals water equals the day after tomorrow levels of horror. Remember that one scene in downtown New York? Yeah, it'd be pretty much exactly that. Bangladesh would be pretty much gone, along with Singapore, Brunei, the Maldives, yeah, those little guys, completely lost underwater. Bermuda, the vast majority of Denmark and the Netherlands would be completely submerged in the new rising surge of oceanic water, forever changing the face of our planet as we know it. The coast of Florida, for the most part, would be completely gone, as well as the vast majority of New York and pretty much all of the United Kingdom's coastline. Now, apply that to pretty much everywhere that meets the ocean. It's good news if you live in nearly any landlocked country though. Mongolia, Switzerland, Kazakhstan, you're all good. In fact, if you're there, it'd be business as usual. But well, actually, that's also not accounting for the huge swathe of global panic and population hysteria that would swiftly spread across the planet. Literally, run for the hills. With all of these millions of people fleeing the encroaching tide and shorelines, where do they go? The world is already facing a continued global refugee crisis, but with Antarctica melting, it would apply to pretty much each and every person on the planet. Economies would be obliterated as a mass displacement of the human population occurred. Water sources would be either lost to the tide or contaminated with salt water. Just look at what happened with the destroyed nuclear energy infrastructure of Fukushima in Japan in 2011. Now imagine that on a global scale, everywhere. That's not even accounting for the health crisis that would follow with, according to the World Health Organization, the sanitation-related spread of illness and disease, as well as the elevated temperatures and open bodies of water spreading to mosquito-borne illnesses. Yeah. And also we have the human strain, the rise of tensions as communities and mass populations are displaced across the planet, seeking refuge in above sea level areas, which would very rapidly inflame regional tensions and trigger conflicts on both a local and global scale. Yeah, things don't look very good, do they? As a matter of fact, if all the ice melted in Antarctica, it would be perhaps the most devastating event that our civilization has ever faced. But the brand new unexplored Antarctic terrain left behind from beneath the ice sheets would look kinda nice, I guess. There'd probably be some pretty dope fossils down there too. Hey guys, I'm just trying to stay positive, okay? Hopefully there'll be people around to still explore. Well, there we have it, folks, our answer to what if all the ice melted in Antarctica. If you couldn't tell, it'd be a very, very bad thing. What did you think? Why don't you let us know your thoughts in the comment section down below? If you've got a life's biggest question for me that you just can't keep to yourself, no matter how encompassing or bizarre, make sure to drop a suggestion in the ever-flowing tides of memedom and comment catawumps down there in the ether. If you're a fan of this video, make sure to hit that thumbs up button as well as that subscribe bell, and we'll be seeing you in the next one. As per usual, I've been your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch. You've been watching Life's Biggest Questions, and until next time, you take it easy.